Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to customize the default behavior of Dialog Editor in the Blazor Tree Grid component. Let's start with the coding part. I will open my existing Blazor WebAssembly app with the SyncFusion Blazor Tree Grid package already installed. On the index.razor page, I have included the basic tree grid rendering code and enabled dialog editing. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a SyncFusion component, please refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. You can visualize task details in a tree grid with this code. Let me run the application to show the tree grid. Look, the tree grid displays hierarchical data, and when I double-click a row, the dialog pops out. Now I'm going to show you how to customize this edit dialog using the template option of the Blazor tree grid. Notice here, the approved column is not bound to the tree grid columns, but is in the data source. So, in my template, I will show the approved column and omit the duration column. Now I will render my own editors using the dialog template by wrapping the HTML elements or SyncFusion components in the template property of the tree grid edit settings tag. Within this template, I define a local variable called task and create a new instance of the context class for the business object. Next, I add an element as a wrapper for the dialog content and define other elements to align the dialog rows and columns with CSS classes. Then in the style element, define the CSS styles for these classes. First, I'll use the numeric text box for the task ID column. To use the numeric text box, I must add SyncFusion.Blazor.Inputs namespace. Then I add the SF numeric text box tag. I then do the two-way binding with the numeric text box and tree grid components by using the @bindValue property for the task ID field. I add the enabled property to enable or disable this field based on the add request. I check the data source value and enable the task ID field if its value is 0. I add the placeholder property and set its value to task ID. Also, I add the float label type property to align the label and set its value to always. I mention the value type for this component by setting the tValue property to an integer. Next, I'll use the autocomplete component for the task name column. To use this component, add the SyncFusion.Blazor.Dropdowns namespace. I add an element for a column with CSS classes. Then add the SFAutoComplete tag. Include the data source property and set its value to tree data. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the autocomplete component. Therefore, define the autocomplete field settings tag and map the field task name to the value property. Next, I need to specify the data source type. I define the tItem property and set its value to business object. To specify the value field type, set tValue as a string. I define the @bindValue property with the value task name to support two-way binding across the Blazor tree grid and autocomplete components. Then set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Next, I use the date picker for the start date column. Add the namespace SyncFusion.Blazor.Calendars. I add an element for rows and columns with appropriate CSS classes. Then add the SF date picker tag and set the tValue as date time. Do two-way binding with the date picker component using the @bindValue property for the start date field. Then set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. For the progress column, I add the numeric text box just like the task ID column. For the priority column, I use the drop-down list component. For this, I have already added the drop-downs namespace. I add an element for the priority column with the appropriate CSS class to align it and add the SF drop-down list tag. Now I need to get the distinct priority values from the data source. I declare public class drop-down data with two fields, task ID and priority. Then declare the public variable priority data to store the values. Inside the uninitialized method, store the distinct priority values from the tree data data sources. Then include the data source property and set its value as priority data. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the drop-down list component. Therefore, I need to define the drop-down list field settings tag and map the field priority to the value property. I have the text property to map the priority column from the data table for each list item. To specify the data source type, I define the TItem property and set its value as drop-down data. To set the value field type, add TValue as a string. Add the @bindValue property with the value priority to support two-way binding across the tree grid and drop-down list components. Then set the placeholder and float label type properties with appropriate values. Finally, for the approved column, I use the checkbox component. I add syncfusion.blazer.buttons namespace. I add an element for this column with the appropriate CSS class and define the styles under style element. Add the SF checkbox tag. For two-way binding with the checkbox component, I set the @bindChecked property for the approved field. I have the label as approved and label position as after. Now I will run the sample and show you the dialog. In the output page, when I click the Add button in the toolbar, the dialog will open. You can see numeric text boxes, autocomplete, drop-down list, and checkbox components. After the details are updated, save the changes using the Save button in the dialog. When I click the Edit Toolbar button, the Task ID field is in a disabled state. And I'll modify other fields and save the changes. To recap what we have seen so far, I customize the tree grid editing dialog using numeric text box, autocomplete, date picker, drop-down list, and checkbox components. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.